readings. Let's continue examining the absurdity jihad of Deedat's combat kit. Accusation F, a seven-headed leopard, Revelation 13, verse 1 and 2. Honestly, this one deserves its own video. The context is so rich and so important, more so at this time in history. Revelation 12, 1, and a great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed in the sun, with the moon under her feet and a crown of 12 stars on her head. If you've been aware, you were watching in September of 2017, when cosmic alignments arguably fit this description. That's actually appropriate to consider and not forget that it did happen, especially since the verse says a great sign appeared in heaven. This can mean both a literal sign in the stars, the heavens, and a spiritual sequence that fulfills the imagery John saw. She was pregnant and crying out in the pain and agony of giving birth. Then another sign appeared in heaven, a huge red dragon with 7 heads, 10 horns, and 7 royal crowns on his heads. Spoiler, this dragon is Satan. We shall see this clearly in this passage and in this verse. I'm also going to try to consistently color him red. We see the dragon imagery again in Revelation 20, verse 2. He seized the dragon, that ancient serpent who is the devil and Satan, and bound him for 1,000 years. 12:3. Then another sign appeared in heaven, a huge red dragon with 7 heads, 10 horns, and 7 royal crowns on his heads. The heads, horns, and crowns surely have a meaning, but I will largely avoid that detail in this video. His tail, so this is his, the pronoun his, the antecedent is Satan, so it's in red. His tail swept 1/3 of the stars from the sky, tossing them to the earth. And the dragon, in red, stood before the woman who was about to give birth, ready to devour her child as soon as she gave birth. This third of the stars speaks of 1/3 of something that is not of this earth. We shall see from this entire passage that these are spirits, angels, elsewhere in Scripture called demons. And she gave birth to a son, a male child, who will rule all the nations with an iron scepter. And her child was caught up to God and to his throne. This phrase is ambiguous. His could mean God's throne or the throne of her child. We know that Jesus will be seated on his throne at the right hand of the Father. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where God had prepared a place for her to be nourished for 1,260 days. The woman is not Mary, the physical mother of Jesus' body. The woman is Israel. Then a war broke out in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. And the dragon and his angels fought back. Notice the dragon, Satan, leads an army of angels. But the dragon was not strong enough, and no longer was any place found in heaven for him and his angels. His army of angels was only 1/3 of the heavenly angels, those that followed him. The remaining 2/3 of the angels remained faithful to Jehovah God. And the great dragon was hurled down, that ancient serpent called the devil and Satan, the deceiver of the whole world. He was hurled to the earth, and his angels with him. And I heard a loud voice in heaven saying, Now have come the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ. For the accuser of our brothers has been thrown down, he who accuses them day and night before our God. Have is plural. Now have. Because at this time, 4 things have come. 1, the salvation. 2, the power. 3, the kingdom of our God. And 4, the authority of his Christ. These things have not happened yet. For the accuser of our brothers has been thrown down, he who accuses them day and night before our God. They have conquered him, Here in yellow, this is the Christians, our brothers. In the red is Satan, the dragon, the accuser of our brothers. This now speaks not of a victory by angelic army, but by Christians. They have conquered him, one, by the blood of the Lamb, and two, by the word of their testimony, and three, they did not love their lives so as to shy away from death. They are willing to die rather than reject and abandon the truth. Therefore rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. But woe to the earth and the sea! With great fury the devil has come down to you, knowing he has only a short time. And when the dragon saw that he was thrown down to the earth, he pursued the woman who had given birth to the male child. The anger of Satan will be against Israel. But the woman was given two wings of a great eagle to fly from the presence of the serpent to her place in the wilderness, where she was nourished for a time and times and half a time. Then from the mouth of the serpent, the devil, Satan, spewed water like a river to overtake the woman and sweep her away in the torrent. Satan and all his minions, from Mohammed to Hitler, have hated God's covenant people. But the earth helped the woman and opened its mouth to swallow up the river that had poured from the dragon's mouth. And the dragon was enraged at the woman, and went to make war with the rest of her children, who keep the commandments of God and hold to the testimony of Jesus. And the dragon stood on the shore of the sea. The woman is Israel, yet these hold to the testimony of Jesus. And at last we finally get to the verse Deedat mocks as absurd. Then I saw the beast with 10 horns and 7 heads rising out of the sea. There were 10 royal crowns on its horns and blasphemous names on its heads. Think back to the last phrase of the previous chapter. And the dragon stood on the shore of the sea. Then I saw a beast with 10 horns and 7 heads rising out of the sea. There were 10 royal crowns on its horns and blasphemous names on its heads. So in verse 3, a huge red dragon with 7 heads, 10 horns, and 7 royal crowns on his heads. And in verse 17, then I saw a beast with 10 horns and 7 heads rising out of the sea. There were 10 royal crowns on its horns and blasphemous names on his heads. The imagery is repeated. Satan the dragon was at the shore in the surf regrouping. But did you notice something has changed? 7 royal crowns on his heads and 10 royal crowns on its horns. At first there are 7 crowns on the heads of the dragon, Satan. Next there are 10 crowns on the horns on the beast that arose. I'm going to avoid speculation on the meaning of that difference. So that is the context from which Deedat rips his claim. A 7-headed leopard, Revelation 13, 1 and 2. Deedat does reference Revelation 13, 1 and 2. So let's look at Revelation 13, 2. The beast I saw was like a leopard, with the feet of a bear and the mouth of a lion, and the dragon gave the beast his power and his throne and great authority. In this verse, it is clear the dragon, who is Satan, is separate from this second entity called the beast. And the dragon gave the beast his power and his throne and great authority. His power, his throne. In this context, the pronoun his is ambiguous and could mean either dragon or beast. In one case, it could mean Satan the dragon gave, meaning loaned or delegated, to the beast Satan's power and Satan's throne and great authority. In the other case, it could mean Satan the dragon gave, meaning delegated or created, to the beast power and a throne, and great authority. It does not matter which. In either case, the power and throne and authority of the beast are derived from and linked to Satan, the dragon. But getting back to Deedat's jihad against the Word of God, a seven-headed leopard, Revelation 13, 1 and 2. The verse does not say, a seven-headed leopard. It says, like a leopard. The beast I saw was like a leopard, and adds two more attributes in the description, with the feet of a bear and the mouth of a lion. If you are Muslim, does the Quran actually teach you to be completely daft in how you read? No wonder Islam destroyed Arab culture and thinking that once formalized algebra. How can you learn anything when you cannot see or accurately perceive the very thing you think you try to study? Then I saw a beast with 10 horns and 7 heads rising out of the sea. The beast I saw was like a leopard with the feet of a bear and the mouth of a lion. There is no doubt. From this, CNN would report seeing a dragon in a Trump MAGA hat. But if you are Muslim, you are taught to claim you respect the truth of God's revelations. Whether you believe it or even understand it are another matter. The beast I saw was like a leopard, with the feet of a bear and the mouth of a lion. This does not say was a leopard. But this is what Deedat claims it says. A seven-headed leopard, not something like a seven-headed leopard. Proving once again, Deedat is a liar, and a damned liar. But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the detestable, as for murderers, the sexually immoral, sorcerers and idolaters, and all liars, their portion will be in the lake that burns with fire and sulfur, which is the second death. God lumps liars in with all these other gross sins and perversions. The cowardly and the faithless, meaning infidels, don't believe or repeat Deedat's lies, or you too will wind up in the lake of fire. We'll get to Deedat's next lies and misrepresentations in the next video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.